Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, we will see unidirectional BACnet IP to MQTT Publisher using the Node-RED. And we are going to publish our BACnet IP device data to MQTT Broker in the JSON payload format. Okay, so previously we have covered a video in which we have explained how you can publish your BACnet IP device data to MQTT Broker with the raw payload. Now we will cover the JSON payloads. Now, what is the difference between raw payload and JSON payload? So when you are using raw payload, your each topic will contain one value only. Okay, and in the JSON payload, your one topic can contain multiple values. So that is why it's useful when you have topic restrictions. Okay, so you have limited access to the topic and you want to transfer more number of values, then you can use the JSON payload. So let's see how you can do that in the Node-RED. And here is my BACnet room controller simulator running in my local system. So we are going to use this room controller simulator to read the data, and then we will publish the data to my local host MQTT broker, which is Mosquito MQTT broker. Okay, so here is our room controller simulator, and here is my Node-RED flow, which is useful to read the data from this device and to publish the data to MQTT broker. So yeah, here you can see we have two sections in this flow. The first one will discover the available BACnet devices across the network, okay, and the second one will read the data from any specific device, and it will publish all the data to MQTT broker using this publisher node. So let me clear all the messages from the debug window, and we will inject the timestamp here. So once you inject the timestamp, it will find the available BACnet devices in my network. So it should find this room controller simulator. Okay, so you can see we have a result here. If you expand, then you can see address 192.168.1.8 and the port number is 59550, and you can see the device ID 1867817, and here also you can see the device ID is matching. So this bunch of node has successfully executed and it has successfully find this room controller simulator. Now we can use this section to read the data from this device, okay, simulated device, and to publish the data to MQTT broker. And the MQTT broker I'm using is my own Mosquito MQTT broker running inside my local system. Okay, so what we can do is we can launch MQTT Explorer software to see the data, and I'm going to connect with Mosquito MQTT broker, and I'm connected. Okay, now what we will do is we will inject the timestamp node here. Okay, and you can see it's successfully injected, and here you can see we have a BACnet topic, and inside that topic we have the data like temperature indoor, temperature outdoor, temperature dot water, everything, okay, along with the set point and everything. So it will read the point value and the point name from the BACnet device, and it will publish the point name along with the point value to MQTT topic, which is BACnet topic. Okay, so this is how it is going to be work. Now what I can do is I can, you know, set the interval, okay, for 2 seconds, and I can press on done. I can deploy my flow, so it will read the data at every 2 seconds, and it will publish the data to MQTT broker at every 2 seconds. And here we can take a graph of this data, and we can monitor that data. Okay, so you can see temperature indoor is changing. Okay, it's a PID loop, so it will change and it will settle to the set point. Okay, now if I change the set point to vacancy mode, then it will try to decrease. You can see it's a value 20.8 around. Now you can see the value is decreasing 19. Okay, you can see the value decrease 19.1. 18. Okay, so as per this set point 17 degree, it will try to decrease the value of indoor temperature. And if I change the mode to the comfort mode, okay, then it will again increase the value, you can see, and it will try to set at value 21. And here you can see we have continuous data. Okay, and also you can monitor the data in the graph. So this is how you can use Node-RED to read the data from any device. Okay, it can be physical device, it can be your simulated device, anything. It will read the data and it will directly publish the data in the JSON format to any MQTT topic. Now your one topic contain entire device data. You can see from top to bottom, it will contain entire device data. You don't have to create a separate topic for each thing. Okay, so one topic is enough to contain the entire data. So this is the beauty of the JSON payload. So I hope this thing is clear, that how you can use Node-RED to publish your BACnet device data to MQTT broker in the JSON format. And if you want to buy this flow, then the link is available in the description of this video. You can go there and you can buy this flow. Okay, now you can use this timestamp, or you can say inject node, to discover the devices across the network. Okay, and you can use this node, this set of node, to read the data and to publish the data to MQTT topic. You can change the MQTT topic from this function node. Okay, and you can edit this inject node with this IP address and port number. Okay, so once you open this function inject parameter, okay, you will have the IP address and port number. So according to your device, you can change the IP address and port number in this function node, and then after it will start working smoothly. Okay, so you can see it is continuously reading and sending the data to MQTT broker, and we can see the graph. Now you can use this topic anywhere in any SCADA system or any other platform to extract the data, and then after you can use this data for your analysis, for your visualization, anything. Okay, so I hope this thing is clear, and if you still have any questions or any doubt, then you can always ping me on Telegram, Instagram, WhatsApp, anywhere. And if you want this flow, then the link is available in the description for purchase. Okay, so let's meet in the next video, and in the next video, instead of this package, okay, we are going to use this package to build the same application. Okay, so this is the node BACnet contrib extended package, okay, and which contain let me show you, which contain this set of node. Okay, so which contain this set of node, and if you go for the node-RED contrib BACnet package, then it will contain the different node. You can see BACnet read, BACnet write, and BACnet command. How to perform the same application with this three node, that we are going to cover in the future videos. Okay, so stay tuned for the future videos. Till then, take care, goodbye, and thank you.